Good evening, viewers, and welcome to a special edition of Scoreboard here on at Central Network. And this evening we are at the Coover Recreation Ground, the home training field for the new kids on the block, Diamond Scaffolding Club Sando. A long name, break it down shortly, you know them as Club Sando. No mind in Coover, they are Central, but it's Club Sando. And we will be chatting with the team administrator, the coach, and a couple of the players to find out how the journey has been so far and the build up to the opening of the 2015-2016 Pro League season. Gentlemen, it's a pleasure. Team administrator Edison Dean, yes. Welcome.
Thank you.
And the coach himself, Anthony Street. Gentlemen, we are just maybe a month or so away from the opening of the new season. Coach, how was the preparation? How are you feeling right now?
Well, the preparation was beautiful so far. We started on the 16th of June until today. Well, you know, we start earlier because we're a new team on the Pro League, so we want to be real competitive this season and we want to bring something new to the Pro League.
The last time I spoke to you, you told me that you're going to be bringing something new to the Pro League. We saw during the years in the Super League, Club Sando, one of the teams with that core-based support, you know, always had something different at any matches. The Pro League football is a bit difficult or maybe a little harder than the actual Super League. But again, football is played 11 against 11 on the day of the game. But what have you been working on so far with the members of the team to get them ready for the higher grade, as you say, football?
Well, to begin, I was in the Pro League already as an assistant coach with Sawa Jablute, and then with Superstar Rangers, I was the head coach. And then I come back with W as an assistant coach with Stuart Charles Favier. And I think, you know, from taking up this job with Club Sando, the goals was always to go into the Pro League. Sitting by my boss man here, you know, he is the one who say win the Super League and I carry all it to the Pro League. And first year we run second, and the second year we run first, and he keep to his word, and here we is into the Pro League now, looking to prove ourselves in the Pro League like we did in the Super League. So the sky's the limit.
Right. I know that you have acquired some additional players to the team. Overall, if I'm to ask you, what sort of team, what balanced team you have right now?
Well, to begin with, personally, we wanted to keep the core of the players because the players will work so hard over two seasons to take us to the Pro League. I, as a coach, wanted to keep these players and tell them it's only them could eliminate themselves, you know, by not going through the rigid training and thing for the Pro League. And so far, we have kept the nucleus of the club, the players who will take us to the Pro League, and have a few what we brought in, maybe four or five players we brought in to strengthen, to keep our balance, and so far it's going wonderful.
Sadin.
Yes, sir.
Club Sando has to be one of the oldest, or could be the oldest, you know, team around from, I mean, days of the Fed match coming right up to the highest level of football right now. Where you were the one who said that win the Pro League, win the Super League, we're going to the Pro League.
Yeah.
Now that has happened. How do you reflect on the performance of the team from the Super League now as we go into the Pro League?
Well, the performance of the team has been wonderful. I mean, under Coach Street here, I think this has been the best Club Sando has ever played since the history of Club Sando.
I have to admit, yeah.
Right? The best performances we have gotten for the last two seasons under, actually, this is the best coach I've worked with since we are in existence. I have all confidence in him that we can't do it in the professional league.
What are your expectations for the first season in the Pro League?
Not to be at the bottom of the table. I think we should do well. We have a well-balanced team, and we as the coach said, the sky's the limit. I don't want to say too much about, you know, where we'll be on the table, you know. Yeah. I believe that is jinx. Mm. So I just say we're hoping to do well, and I think we should do well in the Pro League.
Now, one thing Club Sando has, and no one can take away from Club Sando, is that support base, right? How are you all working on that to bring that support base that we saw in the Super League to the Pro League? Because we know in the Pro League, I mean, there are teams that don't have any support. Mm. And that is what is, to me, is hindering performance of players, because I believe that if a player comes out to play, what can motivate him is seeing support, right?
Yeah, well, the support base is still there. Our the main man behind it, a guy called Bernard, which is McKnight's family, and he actually they form a fan club, and they are responsible for all what is going on right now, and we are working together with them to make sure that we have things in place for them to keep supporting the team. So,
Coach, we August about as I said about a month ago. How ready are you? Are you right now? And in what areas you still have to, you know, put in a little bit of extra work?
Well, I think we're 60% ready because, as I say, we start since the 16th of June, and that gives us enough time to prepare because we know we are new in the Pro League, and I have followed the higher leagues in England and all about, and always seeing the team will now come up getting demoted. Mm. And I don't want to go that direction. Club Sando will not be going that direction. Club Sando will always be competitive, and we prove ourselves in the Toyota Classic 2 seasons straight, we could be competitive in this. And now, as I tell the guy, we prepare for this when we was in Super League, Pro League we was preparing for. Now we're preparing for Club Championship. Mm. And that is our goals we set in, you know.
Now, to keep these guys motivated, because the Pro League is a lot more games than the Super League, how do you intend to keep these guys motivated and on top of the game?
Well, the guys keep motivated because I think the owners, Mr. Eddie Dean, and myself, I think I is a kind of live wire around the players. I live with the players, I grow with the players, always keep them around me, you know. So we have a family kind of bond that wherever we at, oh, you see all of us. Mm-hmm. We always moving together, but there is always the discipline gap.
Yeah.
You know, because I is that part, me is discipline. Mm-hmm. And when I now take over the team, Mr. Dean here, say, Anthony Street, discipline is the first thing I want you to deal with, and I tell him that is not the problem. That already solved, you know, and so far I think he had that trust in me, that the discipline part of our team is at maximum, and I think that is why the team has been doing so well so far, because each man respects everybody.
That is one thing I must mention here, is that the couple games that I saw with Club Sando, you know, discipline, I mean, you can correct me, but I can't recall seeing a lot of yellow cards or red cards where Club Sando were involved in games. So I think the discipline there is of a high level. Who are some of the players now that you all will be relying heavily on to take the younger ones, you know, through this full season?
Well, as I said before, the seeded players is the players who was with me 2 years, and they are the ones who understand how the family is, how we grow from home, and they are the ones to pass that baton on to the younger ones who are coming in. Mm. Because we tend to bring in more younger players now because we have more senior players for the past 2 years.
Yeah.
So we just want the transition period. That is what we're getting ready for. The transition, moving the older ones, because they won't play forever.
Yeah,
but we must have the younger ones coming in and crying about themselves in a professional manner.
Well, gentlemen, it was a pleasure. I know that I'm taking up some of your time, you know, in training, but let me wish you all the best. But before I let you all go, people want to know where Club Sando home venue is, where we're going to be seeing games.
Well, we are trying our best to secure the Manny Ramjohn Stadium. We are right now in discussion with them. Well, they know the PFL also, they put the games where they want to.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
we're hoping that Manny would be available to us.
But we are hoping that too, because San Fernando
Israeli staff for football. You know, they have to travel to Atomola and too regular, and you know, Club Sando, the name Club Sando, people tied back with.
Yes.
We could do with some good football and some new football at Manly Ramton. So again, gentlemen. But
just before you go, I just want to say to the public, you know, we are unsponsored and we are looking for that sponsorship to carry the team to our next level. Mm-hmm. And if it's, you know, possible that somebody out there who watching this program could assist Club Sando, we would be thankful for that. You could even come around and watch the team before you put your money into it and see how professional we are without a sponsor. So we're hoping that someday we could own a sponsorship.
Well, I could vouch for that because, I mean, I have been around Club Sando, right? I know it's a disciplined team, it's a hard-working team, and it's a team with a lot of young people. They more or less are in Coover, but more or less they represent South. So, I mean, anybody, you know, want to get involved with sports, a good football team, a new team, feel free to contact Club Sando. If you need any further information, contact us at Ax25 and we'll put you on to the relevant people. But again, Coach and Mr. Administrator, I like that title. Thank you for spending this time with us. I know we're going to talk to a couple of the players before we leave. But again, congratulations on achieving this level to come into the Pro League. And we know that, judging from the last 2 years, Club Sando is definitely going to be a force to reckon with. And they're going to be bringing something new to the Pro League. So thanks again. And we look forward to the opening of the season on the 11th.
First game on 13th up Sandy Grande against Northeast Stars.
Northeast Stars, tough game, but I know you always pull it through. So viewers, we're going to take a short break. And when we return, we're going to be chatting with a couple of the players on Club Sando team. Remember, this is Scoreboard right here on Acceleration Network.
The whistle to commence this final, as I said before, double connection. They're all white. Club Sando in their navy and yellow, and the rhythm section has started. Not being able to get past Williams there. I just found the boot of Lozano. Lozano having a very big impact in their semi-final matchup. So there's this man, Zhao. Lozano, the Brazilian connection, getting it to Neil Benjamin. Benjamin Jr. trying to get there. Yes, he does. He's trying to control, not being able to do so as he's being hounded off of that one. Trying to send one upfield, ricocheting off the body of Benjamin. Still staying with Hashim Asia here. We saw a W connection attack Guaya FC early, often. And it was really too much for Guaya. It was early and late as well. The attack from the minute, from minute zero to minute 90. Guaya having no answer. It's Jovan Jones, one of the goal scorers against Guaya. A magnificent goal, getting past at least five defenders on the way to putting it in the back of the net. There's Lozano. No whistle being blown. There's player brought down, trying to be cheeky. There was Hashim Asia, but it's going to be a free kick here now for connection. Nate Benjamin Jr., one of the quicker players you'd see in Pro League football, trying to get this one across here. Is Lozano. Yes, Hashim Asia. Asia taking a shot. Oh, it's going to be just wide of the goal. Asia on the left-footed shot there. Early and often you can expect from W connection. And the push of the game, goalkeeper Andre Marchand for Club Sando today. Former W Connection player Kern Cupid actually taking that throw. Something you say all the time in football throughout Trinidad and Tobago. So many players have come through W Connection as this cross inside here by Fredericks being knocked out of touch. It's going to be a throw. So many players have started their foundation with W Connection, now playing with other teams in the Pro League, in the Super League. So many players you've seen leave W Connection, return and leave again. Dwayne Charles getting it all the way back to Cornelius Thomas, the former TN Tech player. Trying to get upfield, a beautiful ball here. Is he going to be able to get his boot on it? Trying to get the cross in, but it went out of touch before. Out for a goal kick. And that one, Cornelius Thomas finding Smith, met by Jordao. Richon trying to get it upfield before Jones could have got onto it. Here's Tiba McKnight. No Cyrus in the back for W Connection. He's currently in Vietnam. But even without Daniel Cyrus, the defense is so strong, so rock solid. Lozano trying to get it across here to Neil Benjamin Jr. Using the head and knocking that one away is Kamel Rivers. Silvio Span trying to connect with Benjamin there, but not to be, as it's going to be a goal. Well, back with the goalkeeper, actually. Jamal Williams is on the bench, so the Williams on the field, the 4W connection to start this one are just Jared and Mikkel. Speaking of Jared, there he is, trying to get it up here to Neil Benjamin Jr. Benjamin actually quicker than Kamel Rivers on first couple opportunities he's had. Trying to keep it in play, he's doing a good job of that and being fouled in the corner. It's actually before the foul, before he is brought down. It went out of touch, so it's a throw in favor of Club Sando. Club Sando, of course, some may say it's a Cinderella run. Some may say they have upset the Pro League, but they will be in the Pro League next season. Defeating three Pro League teams on their way.
Welcome.
Okay. Thanks.
And it's a pleasure.
Same here.
When I spoke to you last time, you all were just finished winning the Super League.
Right.
Now, just about a month or so from the Pro League.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I know you played a lot of Pro League football, so right, you would have gained that experience. I don't know for you if you were ever in the Pro League.
a long time ago with Connection.
Right, with Connection.
Yes,
too.
He played with me as well. Yeah.
So really and truly, you all have that experience,
yeah,
right? So I guess the younger players will be looking towards you all to give them that boost.
Yeah.
How has the training been so far? Let me start with you, Kun. Preparation-wise.
Right, well, you know, we have to put the fact that we have a very experienced coach. You know, our coach has been a head coach for so many years at, you know, Rangers. So preparing for a season is it come like second nature to him.
Yeah.
Right. Training has been intense at times. It has been fun at times, you know. He knows how to vary the sessions as to the workload we might put in. Some days we overload, some days we take it on. You know, we had a few practice games in between, and right now the training session has been fun, building the spirit of the squad leading up to the season.
What about you?
I definitely agree with what Kun said because of the fact that his experience knowing the ins and outs of the Pro League, know how much days you have to give rest, how much days you have to be able to train. Myself and I know Kun to a certain extent are kind of aspiring coaches in the future. You could learn a lot of things from him in how to be able to run practice sessions and what you have to do, you know, to be able to have the chemistry between players. And definitely with the work that he's done, Paul has done with us, the preparation, we will be prepared for the Pro League season coming up.
So, what I could see without the question is that since the school has taken over from Sando, because Sando has hit a high, and mm-hmm, we really have to come from that high, you know, going at each game, right, and seeing that the work that he's doing and helping the team. Now, Pro League football, it's a bit different to the Super League. How do you see the younger players matching up? Because there's a lot of football to be played in the Pro League, right? And along the way, condition is going to come in, right? How do you all see the team, the general team, you know, going through the first year? And what are your expectations for the first year in the league?
Starting with the expectations, Club Sando has always been an ambitious club from day one. They have been in the South Zone, came up to the Super League, and going into the Pro League, just even from the days in the South Zone. Keith could tell you about that because he represented them in the South Zone. They have always been an ambitious club. 25 years in existence,
July the 25th, yeah. Right, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, that's when they held the 25th.
Right, so they are experienced club. And we have an experienced coach and we have experienced players amongst the young players, which will always augur well for the future and the makeup of the team. Because I always believe that once you have young players amongst experienced players, they will always learn. And once they're willing to learn, they will always take the club forward. And we have a coach, tactically, is always preparing his team for each game. Every single game is something differently that he brings to the table, and he tries to teach his players the game itself. And going back to what Keith said, the fact that we have players that are aspiring coaches, we could pass on knowledge from him to the players.
Yeah, just to tie off what Kuhn said there, is to make it easier, the transition from Super League to Pro League is just the attitude.
Okay.
So to make it easier for the user, yeah, coming up, you have to give them the confidence.
Looking at when you all play the Super League, the
Pro League teams, yeah.
In the Cup.
Yeah.
I mean, there was no difference.
No, yeah. No.
Held them, eh? Yeah, so.
So it's just a matter of giving them that level of confidence. When you come into something that you're not familiar with, you start off shy in anything.
Yeah, yeah.
If you start off at primary school, secondary school, you're shy until you build your own confidence and put your own 2 feet into the water and see how that is. And then you gain your confidence, you build your confidence, and you grow from there. Like,
yeah, yeah.
Lionel Messi and all these players, they started off and the teammates give them that confidence to play. And with the confidence, you grow. So I think that with us being around and channeling them in the right direction and make it easier for them to be able to play, grow the confidence, and I think we go from strength to strength.
But with the experience that you all have from the Pro League, are there any areas where you feel that, you know, that there's still some work where the players, because sometimes players has to do the individual training,
mm-hmm.
and don't always wait on a coach,
yeah.
Right? Because you will only have training on certain days.
Yeah.
But if you want to be the best in what
that
training,
extra,
you have to be extra. But from that little time in the Pro League, are you all seeing areas where you think that the younger guy needs to put in that extra work outside of the coaching sessions?
Well, as you said before, we played against the Pro League teams a couple of seasons ago, and we held our own because we have experienced players. And as Keith rightfully said, the difference in the attitude will need to change.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel that the experience that we have, players that are able to switch on and switch off at the required time, I feel that with the experience we have, the coach that we have, and the fact that we had at least 2 years to prepare,
yeah, yeah,
more or less 2 years preparation to make sure that we could look at our weaknesses and look at our strengths and try and improve our weaknesses and further fortify our strengths. So I believe that the team, the club, the management, you know, we're very confident that we could hold on and even compete and be up there with the best.
And I will take a different route to Kuhn. I think that our fan base is a good fan base, and the fan base that comes to the games and support us, even at our practice sessions, they motivate us, not just as players, but as individuals to do better and be better in our community. So I think that once our fan base continues to grow and we get more attention coming into the Pro League, I think it will do better for the younger players more, not so much the older players, more the younger players, to give them that confidence to know that, hey, somebody outside watching me. So I have to be able to care about myself in a professional manner for you to get better. Because if you don't have a professional attitude to anything that you approach, you wouldn't be as successful as you should be or could be. So I think the fan base, once it grows, we would go from strength to strength.
I want to give each of you 1 minute to talk to the supporters.
Right.
And let them know why it's important to come out in the Pro League and support Club Sando.
Right, well, not just our diehard supporters, but going into this new season, we hope that we could get even more supporters to come on board, because we're looking to build our fan base, we're looking to build our market. As well, we're looking to build our brand, the Club Sando brand, that has been in existence for 25 years. We're hoping to bring on sponsors on board as well, too. And through seeing our fan base grow, sky's the limit.
And I definitely think the fan base will grow. I have no doubt about it. In terms of Trinidad and Tobago, sports is a way for us to be able to grow and be better individuals, get a lot of youths off the streets in terms of crime and violence. So I definitely think that with our fan base growing, you grow attention. When you get attention, people like to be in what is the now, what is happening now. So I think with the fan base growing, people coming out and supporting, get the youths off the street, and we're going in the right direction. Come out and support us in this Pro League this year.
Sando, a pleasure.
Thank you very much.
All the best.
Same here.
And we're looking forward to something new in the football.
Definitely.
Yeah, there you heard it from two members of the club Sando team. We're going to take a break because there are still a lot more players that
team. A lot of people consider
stay tuned, be right back.
The cream of the crop, the class of Trinidad and Tobago's professional football. Currently undefeated this season, actually winning every single game they've played this season. Poor pass there by Jevon Jones, trying to find Lozano. As compared to the crowd that we saw here in the semi-finals, the two semi-final matches, losing teams were Defence Force and Gwaya United. This crowd is extremely small. It was actually traffic to come into the Atabulan Stadium and leaving. Bumper to bumper traffic leaving, but not going to expect that tonight when you see this type of crowd. Still a pretty decent crowd, but for a final, not what you would expect. Club Sando, of course, their first time in the final of the Toyota Classic. Connection, not their first time. Defending champions Caledonia AIA knocked out very early in this one. Brought down there is Jevon Jones, and this may be shot taking distance for him. Actually, it's a foul on Jones. Drayton not being called for the foul there. Poor pass and modest here. Still very early in this one. Players getting accustomed to the surface, getting their passes together. Connection we know in recent years to be a possession team. Like the same possession for long. They do just that. But we saw them against Guayed using the long pass, getting the ball upfield, using the counter-attack effectively. As we see Jawi on the right side, Smith coming on, trying to get it inside to Ashimasia, but getting in the way of that one is Cornel Thomas. Trying to get this upfield. Thomas in unfamiliar territory, being a stopper for Club Sando, actually in W Connections area, but goalkeeper Jelani Archibald actually kicking that one out, says me for three in favor of Club Sando. And Lozano getting it back to Kurt Frederick. Jevon Jones, speedy player with a powerful left foot, a cannon for a left foot. Being guarded by Cornel Thomas. There's Cupid trying to get it ahead of Fredericks. Fredericks losing that one, is back with Lozano. Arcia getting it wide here. Neil Benjamin Jr. He's trying to cut inside. He's doing a nice little job. Here's Lozano. Lozano getting it ahead of wide to Ashimasia. Arcia on the right foot this time. Shot coming in. Goal! Goal, W Connection. In the 11th minute, W Connection strike. Ashimasia in his second attempt of the game. First time he went to the left foot, went right, but went wide. This time, Andre Marchand, no match for the right foot from Ashimasia. Goal number one, and the scoring has begun. W Connection continuing where they left off against Gwaya United, effectively putting that one in the back of the net there. Nice little pass from Lozano, finding Ashimasia as he's now giving him a high five and a hug for the pass. But Hashim doing the hard work and putting it in the back of the net. Goal number one. I have a sneaky suspicion, ladies and gentlemen, that this will not be the only goal we see today. Club Sando, a team that can score goals in bunches, but W Connections defensive line has done such a great job in this Toyota Classic for them. It's going to be increasingly tough to do so against them as Lozano is here with it. He's looking for Ashimasia. Here's Jones getting it to Williams. Lozano again. Well done again in the way of that.
As we continue our discussion here with members of the Club Sando FC, I have with me two more players, Jack Whedon and Kevin Woodley. Jack, it's a pleasure. Kevin, I know most of you all who were watching that game between Club Sando and I think it was Phoenix of Tobago, the man who do all the kind of madness, like this man here. gentlemen, Club Sando now has progressed through the Super League, two successful years. Now we are going to the Pro League, top level football in the country, the highest level in fact. Let me start with you, Jack. What's your expectation? How are you feeling right now going in into the Pro League?
I mean, I think we're in a good position in that people, they wouldn't expect the most from us, but like, we're quietly confident because, you know, we've had a strong squad together for a while, and I think the continuation, not cutting the squad up, we're moving up with all the same players. We're confident of doing well. We want to be competitive. You know, we want people to like the way we play, and I mean, where we finish. But
tell us a bit about Jack, your footballing career.
Well, I was born in England. I'm kind of an adopted home for me. I came here when I was about six, so I just grew up playing Northern Savannah League with Rangers, and went away to university for a little bit, and now I've been back. I played with Westside in the Super League a few years, and last year.
Yeah, that's where you came from.
Last year Coach Street he got me in about halfway through and I really enjoyed it, so
yeah.
I like the way it's set up, I like the training, and so I'm happy here. So yeah.
So you are anticipating a great season for yourself?
I think we have the players to surprise people this year, yeah. And like I said, I think the fact that we've been together for a while now, I think we'll surprise people.
Kevin, tell me a bit about yourself. I know you're supposed to be heading to Barcelona. Tell me about that stint. What's it about?
I'm seven aside, hockey post from the side. I think in the T7.
Yeah.
We play like a tournament in the Atobolan Stadium. We come like second in the competition. Yeah. Score couple of goals in the tournament, so I get picked to go.
Oh, I know you're from Tobago, right? How long have you been a member of Club Sando?
I could say about a year, 1 year.
And how has that year been for you?
Yeah, well, it's a good year. Second year I played the Super League. The second year I win it with Club Sando, so that.
What's your expectations for the new Pro League season? How are you feeling? Any
butterflies, I play Pro League couple years, and no stress.
So you'll be bringing some experience to the younger guys?
Yeah.
What's the camaraderie like with Club Sando? I know that it's like a family unit, but let me start with you, Jack. How's the camaraderie with Club Sando?
I could honestly say, of all the places I've played in Trinidad, and I've played for a while here, this is the best bunch of guys that I've played with, and the most, it's like a family atmosphere, it really is, and people look out for each other, and new guys could come in and they're welcome straight away. So I have nothing but good things to say about I think I'm lucky to be playing here. You know?
As a player, right, what would you like your team to accomplish in the first year in the Pro League?
To be honest with you, I haven't thought about it too much. It's a long season, so I think we just have to start strong, get fit. We played a lot of these teams before in cup runs and stuff, and we held our own, so I think we know the standard. A lot of these guys have played at that level before, so it's just I think we just have to be ready, and I think personally, at least mid-table and maybe pushing higher. Yeah. And who knows, maybe we could push towards the top. So we'll see. Yeah.
See, Jack.
Thanks.
Pleasure.
Yeah.
It's a pleasure. Let me wish you all the best. We're going to take another break. Remember, we are at the recreation ground and we're trying to talk to as much of the players involved with the Club Sando team. So we're going to take this break and come back, and we're going to talk a couple more of it. So this is Scoreboard right here on Axe 25.
Goes all the way out for a goal kick. He had the opportunity there. Did Rodel Alcock coming up from the back, but missing on the head. It was swung inside nicely. Exactly the type of corner you'd hope for if you're going up for the head. The mic man for Club Sando making his voice heard. He's not just on the mic, he's also blowing a horn as Karen Smith is trying to get to this one. It's punched up in the air, but held on to there by goalkeeper Graham. Corey Thomas there being infringed. Seems like an unfortunate foul call because on going up for the head, his head actually collided with the arm. Of Devon Jostling. Balthazar. Nice little turn there by Marvin Jones as he finds Devon Jostling. Richard Roy is with it now. We're trying to push past Cornel Thomas, but not being able to as Kumel Rivers is onto it. Send that one on a touch for a throw. Jostling. Gonzalez. Jones, another cross inside as it's headed up by Quinn Thomas. I said every time the ball comes inside in his direction, he seems to win the head. This one sent up field by Cupid. Carter trying to get it to Roy, not being able to. Here's Roy now. He has Russell wide, but he loses it. Russell trying to win this from Modest. He does, but he's being brought down in the process. For the defense force. Ball inside by Gonzalez. Marchand going up there, and miscommunication between Marchand and defender, and Cornel Thomas there trying to make amends, still fighting in the area, out. Cornel Thomas colliding with Marchand. Marchand eyes was on the ball, so was Thomas as he collided, but not being to pay for it is Club Sando. Jostling with another very best pass. There's Kamel Rivers is here. Sebru is on him. Cleared out and coming off the body of Sebru. So it's going to be for a three in favor of Sando. Anthony Paris being brought down there, so it's going to be with Club Sando. Head coach Anthony Skeet for Club Sando has yet to take a seat since this game has begun. He's been standing on the very edge of his coaching box all game long. As there's the chance of Sando are back.
Welcome back, viewers. Welcome back to Scoreboard right here on Access Channel. We're going to have two more players from the Club Sando team joining us here. I have your Ahmed Gidari. Ahmed recently completed your last year with Napoleon College last year.
Yeah.
And they were also successful in the College Premier League. And I have my good friend and neighbor, Kevon Neves. Kevon, a stalwart with Club Sando, and one of the players who more or less were with the team last year, a former TNTech player too, a player with some Pro League experience. So we have one with experience and one new player coming into the Pro League. Let me start with you, Kevon. You are accustomed with Pro League football.
Yeah.
After TNTech, you came with Club Sando and spent 2 years in the Super League, now back into the Pro League. Where do you see Kevon fitting in the Pro League season and assisting Club Sando based on the experience that you have gathered at the highest level of football?
Well, based on the experience I've gathered from the highest level of football, I expect to be one of the leaders on the team with Club Sando. You know, we have a lot of young players, aspiring players. We have the Humphreys, we have this youngster here, and we have a good mix of experience and youth. So I expect that we would do very well in the Pro League this year. You know, I expect to help guide the team, physically, help carry the instructions of the coach on the field, and along with the other senior players, lead the team into a good solid season in the first year with Club Sando in the Pro League.
How is your preparation going for the season, training?
I think our preparation is excellent. The coach did his homework and mapped out a very good program to suit the needs of all the players. So I think we have everything in place for the upcoming season.
Not much is known about Kevon Neves. You know, you won a scholarship. Tell us a bit about your career in football, where it all started.
Well, it started at St. Anthony's College, basically, well, Harvard. And from Harvard, I attended St. Anthony's College, where I won 3 intercol titles. I received a scholarship to go to the University of South Florida. And from there, I made my debut in the national team right before the World Cup in 2006 as a 19-year-old. I played U20 football, U23 football, coming up with the national team as well. I had a small stint in Sweden, and I came back home after and played with TNTech, and was having on and off the national team ever since. I tried to balance both school and football all the days of my life, but now it's just work and football.
Yeah, so your eyes are not set on going back to the national team, or if that should happen?
I mean, depending on the circumstance and the situation, you know. As a footballer, you always have aspirations to play at the highest level. So, you know, as long as the opportunity arises and fitness is there and the time allows it, why not? Why not play for the national team?
Ahmed, you had a very successful college's Premier League season, captaining Napoleon College. Now that you have come into the big boys of football, how are you coping right now?
Yes, we did. I mean, in a Prima College last year, we came more successful. The atmosphere here at the Pro League team, I mean, is much different, you know. Discipline to come out and work hard. It's not like schoolboy football anymore. I mean, it's big men coming up against on the Pro League. I haven't had any experience in the Pro League, but, you know, this year, hopefully, will be my first year at the Pro League. We're training very hard, and hopefully we get good results.
What have you taken out of the last year in school, where they brought the Premier League? Because that gave the teams like NAPS the opportunity to play teams that they would not have played before. So it was a bit more competitive in your final year. What have you taken out of that you feel you can bring to the Pro League and really benefit you?
Yeah, most definitely. You know, that Premier League, you know, I thought was a very good idea. Yes, it was very competitive. It made the league much more better. You know, you had to travel and sort like that. The league more very competitive. I'm hoping that to bring out my best in the Pro League, because we were training very hard last year, and coming up here now is like a different atmosphere. Totally different atmosphere, as I said. I will try my best to work hard with my team. I just like recently, 2 weeks now, I've been training with this team, and it's like I am falling already. Because I mean, the players, they are just good, motivating you and stuff to work hard. And I really love that about this team. Our coach, Prowler. Coach Prowler, he's a very good coach. Yeah, he pays attention to all his players. And hopefully we'll do good.
Given with the experience you had from playing at the highest level in football, as you said, you will be one of the players that Club Sando will be looking for, to take the team, you know, through the season. But from your experience, when you look at the guys right now, what are some of the areas that you feel that, you know, you still have some repeating and some little, you know, to do?
I mean, the team has taken some shape, but, you know, we're still looking at a couple of players. And, you know, it's up to the coach, basically, to tweak the team to suit himself. But we have players that can fill all the positions. We have solid players in all parts of the field. If I had to guess, I'd say we strengthen up our back line a little bit. Because even though we have a very strong defense, you know, we have to cater for injuries and longevity of players. It's a long season. Pro League seems to be... People look at Pro League and think it's an easy league or a low league, but Pro League is a very physical league, to be honest with you.
A lot of games.
And a lot more physical than even when I played outside. You know, the games are outside are a bit more stretched out, and it's not as physical as the Pro League. The Pro League is a tough league.
No time to recover.
Exactly, the time schedule and the way it changes and stuff like that. You know, so if I had to choose an area to strengthen up, it would be the back line, just because we're probably short a defender or two at this point in time, but we're looking at some players coming in to help us strengthen up the back line. But from the midfield attack, everything go forward, goalkeepers, we're pretty safe there at this point in time.
I guess the youngsters in the team will be looking towards you to really motivate them on and off the field.
Yeah, well, as a senior player, and I've once been a junior player, you know, I had some experiences that weren't very positive, you know, when you're... It's hard being the new guy on a team. And when you come into a new team and the senior players on the team, they don't motivate you. It makes it hard for you to settle down and be comfortable and play.
Yeah.
So as someone who went through that experience, you know, when you guys come on the team, I try to welcome them. And yes, you have to be stern with them, but you know, you have to encourage them as well in order for them to show their full potential, because the more nervous a player is when he comes into a team, the worse he would play. So you know, it's my job and the job of the other senior guys to help the younger players come up to the standard and not cry them down every little mistake they make.
Yeah, because they always make mistakes.
We all make mistakes, yeah. Even as the senior players.
With all the teams that you have represented, with Club Sando, how do you rate Club Sando as a team?
Club Sando as a team, especially for a new team, very well organized. We know what's going on, we have schedules, we have time to keep. You know, we can compare with the Pro League teams easily. Especially for a young budding team, and it seems to be going from one strength to the next strength. So I feel comfortable at Club Sando at this point in time.
What's your expectations for the first season in Pro League?
For the first season in Pro League, I do expect that we'll come out of the top three, and that's a realistic goal as far as I'm concerned with the caliber of players we have. And we have, because we had plenty of players who played in the Pro League before, we have some unknown players that are very exciting players, and you know, we'll come out there and show what we have to offer.
A pleasure, Amit.
Yeah.
We wish you all the best. I know it's going to be a experience for you, you know,
yeah,
you know,
yeah,
a different, you know. So we want to wish you all the best, and we hope that Club Sando will really be the team to be reckoned with in the 2015-2016 league.
Thanks, Judge.
Thanks very much.
We're going to take our final break and return. We're going to wrap up with some of our more players as we continue exposing members of the Club Sando team, the new team in the Trinidad Tobago Pro League 2015-2016 season. We'll be right back after the
spring. And not being able to. Gonzalez there, you losing it. Here's Gonzalez back with it. Jones, ball inside. Cross coming in once more. It's too strong there for Balthazar. Upfield to Modest. But they're trying to be cheeky on the trap and turn, but not being able to get past Elcock on that one. Here's Jostling. Trying to get it to Carter. Easy opportunity, good opportunity. Marchand, good goalkeeping there. Had a very good opportunity. They did. Belgrave, but Marchand came on strongly. It's something he has done quite impressively, knowing when to attack the ball, when to charge, and holding on. Here's Modest. McKnight getting it wide here to Karen Smith. He scored the first goal. Nice of the ball here to Fredericks. He has Modest inside. He's trying to take it further. Alcock pushing down. No call. But he was enough and possibly a bit of a dive from Fredericks there. Can assure you have Sando been down 2-0 instead of being on top 2-0. This crowd here would have been extremely angry with the referee. Here's Jones getting it with Kerry Joseph. Nice little job of screening off his man there by Smith. And a pass from Joseph trickling out of touch for a throw. Just about 14 minutes left in regulation in this one. What can Defence Force do in these 14 minutes? Here's one of the substitutes, Belgrave, trying to push past one. He gets a nice ball here to Carter. Carter inside, a bit too strong, but Balthazar there with a header. Goal number one! Goal number one! So, Defence Force now pulling back one with 14 minutes to go. I said, what can they do? They did just that, putting one in the back of the net. Balthazar being able to convert on that cross coming in. They've been playing that game all game long. Defence Force crossing the ball, but no one being able to get the head on. Right there, they did. And for the first time in this one, being able to beat goalkeeper Andre Marcham. What does Defence Force have in store for us here this evening? Marcham is down. He was down. He's up now. But it seems that Club Sando may be getting ready to make their first substitution of the game. Nice sort of run here by Downing. He's trying to get across and it's going to be out of touch for a goal kick. A corner kick, sorry. That's Dwayne Charles will be coming onto the field for Club Sando, having a word with his coach Anthony Skeet before he goes home. Skeet just letting Dwayne know exactly what role he wants him to play as he steps onto the field. Two goals to one in favor of Club Sando. A team that is representing the Super League, defeating two Pro League teams on the way to 2-1 advantage here now against the defending Pro League champions. As we are seeing Charles coming on the field for the first goal scorer, Karen Smith. Kerry Joseph here. Center field there by goalkeeper Kevin Graham. Here's Joseph. Sending it inside.
Welcome back, viewers. Welcome back to Scoreboard on Axe Television Network, your Tuesday night sports program. And as I said earlier, we are at the Coover Recreation Ground. We are in the middle of a training session with Club Sando. As you know, Club Sando, the new team that is going to be entering the 2015-2016 Pro League season. We have two foreign-based players with us who will represent the Club Sando. They're both from Dallas, Texas. And I have with me Anthony De La Rose. It's a pleasure and welcome.
Nice to meet you.
And Alan Salcido.
Sir.
Also from Dallas, Texas. First time in Trinidad and Tobago, I know for sure. Joining Club Sando. Let me start with you. Tell me a bit about tell me a bit about your footballing experience.
Oh yes, I grew up in the Dallas area. I played with Dallas Texans, which is one of the top youth clubs in the country. Mm. And from there, we went on and played Dallas Cup. I played college ball at University of Central Arkansas and also Midwestern State University. and I got this opportunity to come here and play professional, and I jumped on it.
How long have you been in China?
I've been here for about 2 or 3 weeks.
2 or 3 weeks?
Yes.
How have you been adapting to the football and to Club Sando?
I've been adapting well. I mean, a lot of the players and the coaches and owners, they made me feel real welcome. And it was like I was one of the team as soon as I got here. And I had to earn my spot, and now it's good.
What position do you play?
Central midfield, or anywhere in the midfield. I've been playing right, but I like in the midfield.
What can we, the Trinidad supporters, expect to see from you when you take to the field for Club Sando?
What we can expect, I see myself as a technical player. I like to keep the ball on the ground, pass and move, simple. And when I get in the final third, I like to use my skill and be dangerous.
Yeah. Okay. Alan, tell me a bit about yourself.
I'm originally from El Paso, Texas, and I played for a club there called Boca Juniors, and really good club there. And after that, I moved to Dallas, where I played 2 years in college. And then after that, well, I was gonna transfer, but I didn't have enough credits. So after that, I came to this opportunity. I mean, this is what I wanted to do all my life, so.
How have you adapted to this type of football trip?
Really well now. I mean, now I feel like I'm part of the team. Like, I've been part of the team for like a year almost. I've only been here for 2 weeks.
Yeah, what position you playing?
Left back.
Okay. When you look at the level of football, before joining this team, were you all in a position to know about Trinidad football?
Yes, we heard through our contact, Kerwin Baird, and then we started keeping up with the league through the Soccer Warrior website. I mean, you can tell that there's a lot of technical players out here that just need maybe more funds, maybe a little more experience, but there's a lot of good footballers out here in Trinidad, for sure.
So what's the level, I'm trying to ask you, what's your take on the level of the football in this country?
It's not far from what you say, the Mexican League and MLS League. It's just maybe these little small details that can come
fitness
over time.
Yeah.
Over time, but it's up there. Technically, it's up there for sure.
What with your experience, what do you feel that you can bring to this team that will enhance Club Sando? What do you feel you can bring to the team?
Well, I feel that we can bring maybe a professional, more professional attitude, like more experience playing in big games and in front of a lot of people. And I feel like we can bring stuff like that, you know?
Outside of the training, what have you been enjoying about Trinidad so far?
We honestly haven't really done much.
Yeah.
So we haven't, all we've done is been around this area. So I mean, we haven't really been out there.
Yeah. Gentlemen, it was a pleasure. Let me wish you all, I know I'm going to be following Club Sando, so I'm going to be seeing you all. Let me wish you all the best. And hope you enjoy your stay in Trinidad.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks.